An ogive or cumulative frequency curve is a graphical representation that shows how many observations fall below a particular value in a data set. Let's begin with this frequency distribution where each class interval has a width of 10. To construct the ogive, we first determine the upper bounds of each class. These are the values at the end of each interval. Next, we compute the cumulative frequencies. The first cumulative frequency is simply the frequency of the first class, which is 3. For each subsequent class, we add the current frequency to the previous cumulative total. That is, 3 plus 5 equals 8 for the second class, 8 plus 6 equals 14 for the third class, 14 plus 4 equals 18 for the fourth class, and 18 plus 2 equals 20 for the last class. Note that the cumulative frequency for the last class is the total frequency for the distribution. To ensure the ogive starts on the horizontal axis, we add an extra point before the first class. Its upper bound is the first upper bound 20 minus the class width 10, which gives 10. Its cumulative frequency is 0 since there are no observations below 10. Now let's plot the graph. We place the class upper bounds on the horizontal axis and the cumulative frequencies on the vertical axis. Begin with the point 10, 0, 23, 38, and so on. Then connect the points in order using straight lines. And that's the ogive. From the graph, we can easily see that the number of observations below 30 is 8 and estimate that about 16 observations lie below 45. We can also determine that there are 6 observations between 30 and 40 by subtracting 8 from 14. Next, we can calculate the cumulative relative frequencies by dividing each cumulative frequency by the total frequency, which is 20. And here they are as cumulative frequency percents. The corresponding ogive is displayed here with cumulative frequencies or cumulative frequency percents on the vertical axis. And that's how you construct and interpret an ogive. Thanks for watching.